This program has been brought to you by Cell One and the Friesenbrock Meyer Group.
Welcome to 2015's 10 Most Fascinating People of Bermuda. I'm Lisa Pickering. Everyone has a story, a little something that makes them unique, especially right here in Bermuda. But what does it mean to be fascinating? We've put together a list of 10 Bermudians that captured the headlines in 2015. Whether they've been the subject of controversy or of great praise, there isn't an individual on this list that hasn't come up in conversation around the dinner table, at the office, or at social gatherings. Each individual featured on this list share one thing in common: they all have shown passion, determination, and perseverance in the face of setbacks. The list is in no particular order, but the final subject revealed is this year's most fascinating person of Bermuda. Let's get started. From catwalks to Pharrell's red carpet Bermuda tuxedo, the iconic Bermuda shorts is making a comeback. And riding on this wave of renewed fashion relevance is Rebecca Hanson, founder of Tabs, the authentic Bermuda shorts. In only 2.5 years, Rebecca has taken her bright and bold variety of our quirky business uniform to local and international success, where the demand continues to grow. The shorts have even graced the pages of some of the top magazines in the world. Now Rebecca is expanding her brand, and shorts are just the beginning.
Yeah, it was a bit of a, I was moving back to Bermuda and I didn't have a job at the time, so I was trying to think what I could do with my skill set to bring something to the island. And I was thinking of, you know, what's Bermuda famous for? The Bermuda shorts. Like, everybody in the world has heard of Bermuda shorts, but as far as I knew, no Bermudian was trying to sell them internationally. So I thought there was definitely potential there. So I then went to Central St. Martin's, which is one of the fashion schools out there, and did a course there to learn about how to market a fashion brand and just the basics of the production line and how it works. And then just did a lot of reading and a lot of research over about 2 years. So when I came back to Bermuda, I then kicked off Tabs, but also kept a day job as well for quite some time.
Now, this year alone, that you've expanded into women's shorts, mm-hmm. belts, and then you had the swim shorts with the designer or the painter, mm-hmm. Graham Foster.
Yeah.
That's a successful year in itself.
Yeah, I mean, Graham Foster was brilliant to work with, and his short, you know, everyone loves Graham, so that's been good, and I hope to do some more work with him in the future. But yeah, that's been really fun doing the swim shorts, because I can take, you know, pretty much any image and digitally print it, and, you know, high quality, and they're it's a beautiful product. I'm very proud of that.
Now, Bermuda Magazine named you first ever Made in Bermuda Award this year.
Yeah.
That's exciting.
Yeah, that was a huge honor. I'm not actually made in Bermuda, though. It's kind of designed in Bermuda. We actually manufacture it.
Technicalities.
Yeah. But yeah, that was a huge honor. That was a very good moment this year. I was very chuffed. That was great.
So are you surprised by the support that you've had from the community?
For sure. I mean, Bermudians are so supportive. I can't go, you know... Yeah, I can't thank people enough. My customer especially, they're really involved in the product. They will email me, they will follow up, they'll have ideas. A lot of my products are born from conversations with people. You know, someone will email me and be like, have you thought about doing palmetto green? I'll be like, oh, no, I haven't. Let's do palmetto green. And then, you know, you do that.
There's a huge amount of rules when it comes to wearing the Bermuda shorts. Is that something you came up with, or are those rules the existing? Because, I mean, I see men every day breaking them.
Yeah, they do, I mean, told off. You know, I just researched and looked into the history of the Bermuda shorts and where they came from, and talked to locals as well, which was interesting to see what their perspective was on the product and how they've been wearing it and how they wanted to wear it. But yeah, there is a whole set of rules for wearing them traditionally. And I enjoy sharing that with tourists who come down and visitors.
And now you've expanded into Singapore, and you just were mentioning Dubai as well. I mean, that's quite a feat for just 2.5 years.
Yeah, it's been great. So yeah, Singapore and a boutique out there, and then Dubai, there's some golf resorts that have recently placed an order. But we are international platformers via the website, so I sell internationally through there as well. And it's been really interesting with the America's Cup to see the increase in sales overseas. You know, through the back end of my website, I can see exactly when they're coming. You know, if they're doing a push, they did an article on me in France, and within, you know, 2 hours, I could see the sales of France were going up on the website. So I've definitely seen an increase through that.
Jimmy Chin, I believe his name is, a photographer, was just recently here shooting for a Condé Nast Traveler. Mm-hmm. And he donned your shorts, and I heard that him and his producer were quite impressed with them. And then you were in GQ as well this year, which is quite the feat.
Yeah.
Who would you like to see wearing your shorts in terms of any celebrity out there?
I'd love to see wearing my shorts. Probably sounds a bit bizarre. But Pharrell Williams has been recently wearing them to the, you know, Bermuda shorts, not my shorts, unfortunately. But, and they're a little bit too long, so I need to tell him about that. But he's been wearing Bermuda shorts with the blazer, and he's almost there with the style, and I would just love to kit him out in a pair of tabs with the knee-high socks and just get him to, like, rock it at the Grammys or something. That'd be awesome. But I just can't get hold of him. Trying, you know, he just don't pick up his phone.
I know, you have to send him a sample size.
I know, I should, yeah.
So you've been around for almost 2.5 years, and as you mentioned, you've been working two jobs for almost that entire time.
Yeah.
How did you juggle all these things at the same time?
Yeah, it's a good question, time management. I would make tabs part of my day. So I would get up early, I would go to D'Angelini's, I'm sure they know me very well there. I have my cup of coffee, do hours worth of work on tabs. Then my lunch break would be tabs, and then I'd get home at, you know, 5:36, and I'd work on tabs until 10:30, 11 o'clock. And then you've got the weekends. So when you start to divide your time that way, you can start to fit extra things in.
What are some of the challenges entrepreneurs face? And some people have great ideas, but they don't always make great entrepreneurs.
Yeah, I think the first step is you have to be really realistic. Like, is the idea going to work? You know, put the research in, run the numbers, make sure that it has longevity. And one of the advice that I gave that workshop was don't quit your day job. I mean, it's really tough. But I guess my feeling is you have to be prepared to do it, and you have to love it enough to do it, because it's going to be hard. There's going to be long hours. You're going to make mistakes. There's going to be financial pitfalls at times, but you have to love it enough that it kind of gets your pulse racing and gets you up in the morning. Otherwise, you're not going to last.
Earlier, you told me a great story about seeing your product out there internationally when you were visiting New York.
Yeah.
Tell me that story again.
That was a very cool moment. So I was in New York on a little holiday, and actually I wasn't on holiday, I was working. but I was over there, and across the platform I was about to get on the subway, and I saw a guy wearing my Bermuda shorts. And they're so distinctive because of the color and the triangle logo. It was like a little bit of Bermuda had just washed up into New York. That was a moment where I was like, you know, this is starting to spread now.
So that was a moment that you almost felt like you made it. What do you think will have to occur for you to actually feel super successful and that this brand has taken off?
I'd like to be in more department stores internationally. I'd like to be a globally recognized brand. These are all long-term goals. It will take a long time. I'd like the world to know what Bermuda shorts are really made of. I think I feel successful when I'm like in, you know, Barney's or something. It would be good.
Summers Cooper had mentioned in an article in November 2014 that the reaction was unprecedented and that the demand has outstripped supply. Did you expect this kind of reaction?
No. No, I didn't. Hence why I didn't have enough stock. I didn't. It's been amazing. I'm very lucky to have the support of Coopers. They've been huge cheerleaders for me. It's been a real roller coaster for sure. We've grown really quickly, but at the same time, I want to do more. So it's constantly like pushing forward and growing bigger.
An empire.
An empire, yeah. Everyone will know what Bermuda shorts are, hopefully. I'd love tabs to be like the Hoover of vacuum cleaners. So like, when people say Bermuda shorts, it's like, oh, have you got your tabs on?
And any thoughts of opening your own store?
At some point, that would be great. I'd love to have a flagship, but that will take some time. But we'll get there.
Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you check out Bernews every weekday up until January 28th for more conversation with Bermuda's 10 most fascinating people of 2015. And please, if you know of any individual who you think deserves to be on this year's list, let us know by emailing us at bermibios@gmail.com. Thanks for watching.
This program has been brought to you by Cell One and the Friesenbrook Meyer Group.
With Cell One, you simply get more. More 4G speed and reliability across the island. More warranty coverage from the only carrier authorized to resell Apple iPhones in Bermuda. More first-class service with our 24/7 customer care, whether you're in-store, on the phone, or online. More services, mobile phones, long distance, and home internet, all with one company. Get more with One. Cell One.